¡Ay, Dios! ¡Ando de mi vida!
Did you say idios? Was that the same thing in Spanish? I think I got it. Hi, this is Dr. Theron with Consuelo. She is from Indio, and they have come out for a two-week program because she's in a world of hurt. She has trigeminal neuralgia for how long? Since 2017. And so that's a couple years, and so they're looking for answers, and they're here. They've seen some of my videos and came in and rushed over here. She speaks only Spanish, so her daughter's going to translate. Okay? So, Consuelo, why are you here?
¿Por qué? Porque me duele el trigémino, el neuralgia del trigémino.
Yeah, trigémino. I mean, trigeminal neuralgia, I think. Okay.
Sí. And, y quiero que me cure, por favor. A ver si puede curarme.
Okay. And so, what did you say?
Oh, she said we can make her better.
Oh, good. Yes, make her better. So, what is the pain? Tell us about the pain.
¿Dónde?
Tell us about it. Tell everybody what does it feel like.
¿Cómo se siente? ¿Qué dolor?
Oh, es un dolor muy fuerte que me da aquí, que no puedo. Me duele mucho para comer, para lavarme los dientes, para caminar, para todo, doctor, para todo me duele. Yeah.
So she has tons of pain. Now tell us about eating. Does it hurt to eat? When does it hurt?
¿Cómo te duele?
Cuando empiezo a comer me duele el 10.
Yes, when you eat, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. What have you done for treatment? Have they gone any treatment? Any treatments?
Tratamiento.
¿Qué te han dicho de tratamientos?
Para el dolor, pastillas para el dolor y vitamina B.
What is that?
Just vitamin B.
Vitamin B? Uh-huh. Any doctors at all?
Yeah, just medication.
Medication?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so medication, any other chiropractors?
No.
No? No. Acupuncture?
No.
Now tell us about your headaches. Cabeza, te duele. How often do you have that?
Sí, sí me duele. Y más cuando me da mucho el dolor, me duele.
Uh-huh. Is every day?
Every day. Well, yeah, she said whenever it gives her the pain, on her head hurts.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And then what about the dizziness, the mareado?
Mareada?
How often?
Cada que te mareas.
No, mareada casi no. Casi no, muy poquita.
She says she's dizzy all the time. In the morning, she gets up and gets a little dizzy.
¿Que
en
la mañana te despiertas?
Oh, en la mañana. Pues sí, a veces en la mañana, sí, yes. Cuando me levanto.
The reason I'm putting this all out there, guys, because anybody who's watching this needs to understand these all go hand in hand. Mm-hmm. So they're all going to improve as we get forward, but I want to kind of get a baseline for where we're at. Tell us about your sleep. Dormir.
Oh, no.
No, you sleep? No sleep?
No.
Bad? Good.
No duermo.
Where
no, she doesn't sleep.
Gotcha. How about her falling? She says she falls too.
Oh, que te caes. Las caídas.
No, pues no sé. ¿Cuándo me caí? Como en febrero.
February, she says she fell.
Yeah, she falls. Abajo. Any pain? ¿Te duele?
No, poquito los pies aquí.
In appearance, okay, gotcha. Uh-huh. Like this. ¿Dolor?
No, muy poquito aquí.
¿Poquito? ¿Cuánto?
Un poquitito.
Poquito tito. Okay, look down like this. Cuello, look down. Good. Pain? Arriba? Pain? Okay, so now, a little stretch. Okay, so now we're gonna let her squat. She's a really good squatter, so pay attention. So legs out like this. Okay. She's really good at this. ¿Cuánto? ¿Dónde?
Todas las piernas.
How much? ¿Cuánto?
Ocho.
Ocho, good. She gave me a number this time. She said it was mucho before. At least we got that. Isn't that fun?
Nueve, ocho, nueve.
Okay, so now we're going to ask her about her face. About her face pain. How much pain does she have?
¿Cuánto dolor?
¿El dolor? Mm-hmm.
Ocho also? Gotcha. And she's having trouble talking and articulating because it hurts so much. You ready to go? Boca arriba. Andale. Good.
Ay, hombre, ya.
So much drama. Okay, so x-rays are really messed up, as you would think with this. Really bad TMJ. You can see it in her jaw. Her whole jaw shifted to the side a lot, so there's probably a little bit of that also going on. Tons and tons of arthritis in her back. from top to bottom. She's just one hurting sister.
There is so much here. 5mm right imbalance, terrible occiput tilt, right TMJ. Here we have a 12mm right short leg, 12mm left pelvic rotation, and arthritis. Here we have 130mm forward head carriage, 1/3 atlas wear, and arthritis. Here we have severe low back arthritis and rib calcification.
Mm-hmm. Respira.
Oh, idios. No, de mi vida.
Did you say idios? Was that the same thing in Spanish? I think I got it.
Ay, Dios.
You idiot. Mio. Idiot, me.
No, ay, Dios mío. Ay, Dios santo. Ay, Dios mío.
Why she call me idiot?
No.
I'm a Minos idiot.
Dios mío.
Oh.
No.
Anyways. Uno más.
Ay.
Okay. Respira. Okay. So can you explain to her that after she gets up, when I tell her to get up, no twisting her neck, no turning her neck, no looking up and down, just look straight ahead. The more she does all that stuff, the more she's going to undo my work.
Cuando te levantes, ama, que nomás mires derecho, que no muevas el cuello, no estés moviendo la cabeza. Okay?
We're just going to lift Consuelo up here nice and easy now. Now we're telling her not to twist and turn or she will undo my work. She's a little bit lightheaded after that adjustment. You can see it in her eyes. So we're going to send her down the hall to recalibrate. As you see her go down the hall, she's walking really tense. So right now I'm kind of reminding her to relax her shoulders. Drop them. Do it again. Go again. And she pulls them back and I tell her, right down, down girl, down girl.
Ask her how she feels. Anything different?
Pues mi cuerpo, mi cuerpo lo siento más, ¿qué será? Más liviano, más livianito.
Does she feel a little bit lighter?
Lighter? Gotcha. Very important, abajo with the hombros. Nah, that's better, like that, much better, okay? Now let's see how you feel. Go ahead and bend over, touch toes. Abajo, good. Okay, no pain, like this. No pain, right? Okay, look down. Cuello, yeah. Okay, arriba. We just do this always afterwards, guys, because we want to just make sure we check before and after. Okay, now we're going to squat. There you go.
Okay.
That was ocho before, right? Uh-huh. What is
no.
it now?
Cuatro.
Cuatro. Uh-huh. A little better. Uh-huh. Okay, do it again. Uh-huh. One more time. Look, guys. See, you can see it much better, right? Much better. Uh-huh. Now, last one, how is your face? It was ocho before there, too. Oh, it was ocho or nine?
No way, babe.
It was an eight, right? Same?
Siete.
Siete? Okay, it's just a tiny bit better, okay. Suela, how are you doing this week?
Esta semana, ¿cómo te sientes esta semana? ¿Cómo has estado esta semana?
Esta semana he estado mejor de lo que yo pensaba. Yo no creía que me iba a aliviar de este dolor, pero ahora estoy viendo que sí, que el doctor sí me puede aliviar. Gracias, doctor.
Oh. I was like, I thought you were going to hit me for a second there. Anyways, I guess I should learn more Spanish because she could be saying all sorts of bad things there. Okay, so she came in for trigeminal neuralgia, guys. This is a big case because most people don't get any improvement in the world, and I see these all the time now. So tell us about your pain in your jaw.
El dolor que te da en...
Dolor.
Uh-huh. Okay.
How has this changed over the week? I know it's
¿Cómo
gotten better.
¿Cómo ha cambiado ese dolor?
Oh, el dolor ha cambiado... Sí, ha cambiado bastante. Porque antes yo no podía lavarme los dientes, comer, me dolía mucho, hablar, mirar para abajo, para los lados. Y ahora sí ya puedo hacer todo esto gracias a mi Dios y al doctor.
So
ya estoy bien, muy bien, gracias.
So she wasn't able to brush her teeth,
gotcha,
eat,
before.
Talk,
gotcha, gotcha.
Move, you know, her. Look.
Uh-huh. And that for quite a while, too.
Right.
It was for a couple of years.
Yes.
Dos años. Uh-huh. And so, at the beginning of the week, you're a 10, mm-hmm. right? 10 mm-hmm. out of 10.
Yes.
What is it now?
Ahora, ahorita.
Siete, right now? Or seis?
Seis.
Ocho. So it's come down to about 20%, 30% consistently. Now, today we had a home run. So mm-hmm. today, we've been talking to her all week about posture. And so posture is really important. So I'm going to have her just explain posture and how it's changed. But she went to a zero today, mm-hmm. which is our first time she went to a zero. Mm-hmm. And she did it twice, and she controlled it. And so when she did what I told her, she did really well. And so the daughter and the mother both learned a lot today. And so share that with us.
Que les digas ahora que bajaste a cero, ¿qué es lo que pasó? ¿Tu postura? ¿Cómo llegaste a cero?
Sí, como el doctor me indicó cómo caminar, con mis manos para abajo y mirando hacia el frente, eso es lo que me ayudó a mí ahorita. Y también los dolores que me da aquí, a mí como que no, sí, también.
So she went from a zero to a five. On the first lap she walked, she was a zero, and then she went to a five. Why did she go to a five? Because she walked too fast. She stopped thinking sí. about what I was doing, and she went back to what her old habits, which happens all the time, guys. Mm-hmm. It's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. And she ain't old, but it's a little hard, okay? And so her daughter goes, Mom, slow down. Uh-huh. And she slowed down a little bit. What happened?
Despacito. Caminar despacio. No ir a la carrera. Ir caminando, mirando para el frente, lo principal.
She has mm-hmm. a great little dance. If you will get the dance on by the end of the week, when she walks down, she's like this. Mm-hmm. She's a little hipster. She's a hipster. And what is her favorite mm-hmm. song on radio too? Remember her,
what,
her
Pitbull?
Sister? Yeah, Pitbull.
Oh yeah,
Pitbull. Tremendo culo.
get it.
Take your time. Good. There you go. Good.
Ahora ya no. Ahora ya no es Dios mío. Ya no.
Good. We were on a roll with her. She was kicking ass and taking names until yesterday, actually. She's kind of backtracked it, and so we're realizing that there's some psychological issues that are going on here. Her husband's blind, and so she has a lot of work, extra work that she shouldn't have to be doing at this age. And he's, you know, very hard and he uses her as her crutch. And so there's a lot of emotional stuff going on here too. So she's been doing wonderful. I'm gonna let her talk about this. I'm actually shocked where she is today. We can get her out of pain. She's been out of pain so many days now, and she understands what's going on here. Again, there's just other issues going on. I think we're gonna work through those eventually, but I wanted to get it at this video so you guys can see that I give full disclosure. I want you guys to understand that it's not always a straight line. Sometimes people aren't perfect when I think they're gonna be. And so, Consuelo, tell us how you've been the last 2 weeks. What's gone on here?
¿Qué ha pasado en las dos semanas?
¿Qué ha pasado? Pues, yo siento que sí he mejorado, pero tengo que hacer lo que el doctor me indique para yo poder mejorar. Es lo que yo siento. Sí me duele, pero yo siento que me dolía más antes de venir. Sí me duele todavía, pero haciendo lo que él me indica, se me pasa el dolor. Y pues ahorita estoy en tratamiento con él. Y yo deseo curarme, por eso estoy aquí con él. Y vengan con él, que sí los cura. Nomás es hacer lo que él indica y sí se alivia uno. Vengan con él, es muy buen doctor.
What'd you say? I just think that she's just kissing my ass right now, which I like.
She did say you're a good doctor.
Yeah, we've worked really hard with her. We love this girl. She's been really wonderful. The whole family's great. The Spice Girls are all, they're wonderful here. They have six daughters. So I've nicknamed their daughters all the Spice Girls because they all have this personality. Anyways.
El porcentaje de lo cuando empezaste ahorita, que si ha bajado, subido, ¿cuánto dirías tú que es?
And take today into consideration, but all together, just as an overall whole.
De todo, las dos semanas en que, porque llegaste con mucho dolor.
Mucho dolor, sí, mucho, sí llegué con mucho dolor. Todavía lo tengo, pero yo siento que he mejorado a ese dolor. Ahorita lo puedo calmar con lo que él me diga, y antes yo no sabía cómo calmarlo. Y ahorita haciendo lo que él me indica, sí lo puedo calmar.
¿Cómo a qué porcentaje?
Porcentaje, como de 10, ahorita lo tengo como en 7.
Okay, so about 30% better, right? Something like that. That's what she thinks. We've gotten her to go from 10 out of 10 pain to 0. And that happened this week lots of times. We've taught her how to control it at home, how to get rid of it. Just an hour ago, she was able to walk around the block, which she couldn't do last week. It was no pain. Sit in the car, pain comes back. So we have situational pain here with her, which we controlled that too. So the cars are different. We're going to go work on the car in a second and get her to sit a little different way. But again, she's on the cusp of getting really better here. And so I'm kind of surprised where, how bad it is today. But again, full disclosure, I want you guys to know where it's at, okay?
¿Cómo has mejorado?
Sí, porque hace la semana pasada. Sí.
Since before, this whole last 2 weeks.
Antes.
¿Qué es la diferencia?
Has it improved? How about that? Has it improved?
Sí. Sí, antes de las dos semanas sí he mejorado de dormir, porque duraba días que no dormía en toda la noche, ni en el día, ni en todo el día, y ahorita sí puedo dormir. Sí puedo dormir en la noche. Me despierta una vez, pero ya lo demás duermo.
La cabeza.
Antes te daba el dolor. Antes sí me dolía mucho la cabeza con el dolor. Ahorita no. De vez en cuando, muy, que tenga muy fuerte el dolor, sí me duele, pero ahorita ya no. Dolor de cabeza. No tengo.
And she had that every day before.
¿Y ahora?
No, ahorita ya no tengo.
So, we actually added this adjustment in, which you guys are going to be surprised I do this. And the reason for this is because her kyphosis in her back is so great, and she was having trouble standing up. And so normally I can get patients to stand up better with a good posture from the neck, but she just wasn't accommodating. So we've been adjusting here. So go ahead and breathe in for me.
Yeah.
And breathe out. Exhala. Good. Okay. Una más. Una más. Respira profunda. Exhala. Good. Perfect. Okay, boca arriba. The best combination of adjustments has been that lower thoracic adjustment and this mid-cervical adjustment. And again, why am I doing the mid-thoracic adjustment? Because I want her to have the ability to have better posture. Okay. Good. Bueno.
Hey, bueno.
Yeah, okay. Where are you at with the mouth right now?
Ahorita no. Ahorita no tengo dolor.
No,
me siento bien.
Much better,
Cero.
Yeah. Zero. So, again, last week, if you watch some of the videos, she went from 10 to 7 to 6, which means 6. And so, today, I can get her to go from 10 to 0 like that. But then she goes from 0 to 10 like that. So, the problem is, again, try to control her and get her educated more. And she's getting educated, and we're getting there. And we're really trying. I think we're gonna get this taken care of. But I hope you guys enjoy that. Anything else you want to say?
Oh, pues ya ahorita me siento bien.
Good.
Ahorita estoy contenta.
Anyways, I love this girl.
Gracias, doctor.
Yes, exactly. Sí, gracias. So she's doing a lot better than she thinks. She wouldn't be hugging me if she wasn't. See you guys later.